We're pulling!
What's up? It's Jeff from MediCheck Pull, and this is our official boss guide for Paintsmith Raznal on Normal and Heroic. This fight has two alternating phases. Phase 1, where you're fighting the Paintsmith himself, and Phase 2, which is kind of just an intermission where you're dodging stuff. Each Phase 1 gets slightly more difficult, so it'll likely be best to hold Bloodlust for the final Phase 1 to try and get through the hardest part of the fight as fast as possible. So in Phase 1, there's three mechanics to watch out for and a fourth on Heroic. Number 1, and the most important, a row of spiked balls occasionally spawn on a random side of the platform and slowly roll across the platform, one-shotting anyone they hit. To keep everyone alive through this, you need to quickly burst one of the balls down to destroy it, creating a gap that everyone can run through. We think it's easiest to destroy the ball in the very middle, so have someone mark it as soon as it spawns or place world markers before the pull to be able to quickly identify which one to focus down. By the way, some classes can just teleport to the other side of the balls every time, so definitely take advantage of that too. Number 2, a few random players occasionally get a debuff that puts these chains around them. The chains do heavy dot damage to the debuffed players, but they also knock back and damage any other players that come into contact with them. They aren't a huge deal until a bunch of people have to quickly squeeze through a small gap surrounded by one-shot death balls. Your best bet is to let all the people who don't have the chains get through the gap first, and then the chained players can run through one at a time. If some of the chained players have teleports, this makes it so much easier. And number 3, the boss occasionally marks the current tank with an arrow and a black circle, and then throws his weapon at them after a few seconds. When the weapon hits, it does a ton of physical damage to the tank, fall off damage to everyone in the raid, applies a typical taunt swap debuff to the tank, and spawns spikes that erupt from the floor. So every time the tank gets marked, they need to quickly run to a corner of the room away from everyone else and use a defensive cooldown. And then the other tank needs to taunt the boss. The erupting spikes on the ground do a ton of physical damage and stun you if you're hit. And they move super fast, so you have to be on point when dodging them. On Heroic, the fourth mechanic is traps that the boss occasionally throws on the ground. These traps do big raid damage when they're triggered and apply a short debuff to the raid that massively increases the damage taken from future traps. The traps can be triggered by players, but they also can be triggered by the erupting spikes and the spiked balls. So we suggest assigning one person to run around stepping on the traps one by one, letting the previous debuff fall off before triggering each one. If you're too slow to trigger the traps manually, multiple will probably get set off at the same time and wipe the raid. So be quick, but not too quick. In Phase 2, the boss retreats and waves of spikes are spammed from the front of the room. These are super fast, but there's a gap in each wave that you need to run through to avoid them. Easy enough, but you also have to dodge these random swirlies on the ground that do a ton of damage if they hit you. All the while, the boss is pulsing raid damage and stacking a dot debuff on everyone that lasts for the rest of the fight, which is another great reason to save Bloodlust for the end. Alright, so quick recap. In Phase 1, focus kill the middle spiked ball and run through the gap to survive. Spread out with the chains and try not to run into other people if you have them. Tanks, quickly run the boss's weapon throw cast to a corner of the room and taunt swap after every cast. Everyone dodges the spikes that come from the tank getting hit by the weapon. And on Heroic, avoid accidentally stepping on the traps and have one person run around stepping on them after each one of their debuffs wear off. In Phase 2, dodge waves of spikes coming from the front of the room and dodge swirlies on the ground. And that's pretty much it. You can find our written version of these guides on Icy Veins linked below. Thanks again to all of our supporters on Patreon for making these guides possible. Like, subscribe, and join our Discord to keep up with everything Ready, Check, Pull. Peace.